Hi guys, it's Danny from Inglorious Fishing. It's currently a Thursday afternoon, well, lunchtime, and we're going to go up to the turbot banks. We're going to go back up to Bankdonall where we've been the past couple of days, and we're going to see if we can get a few turbot, baby. So stay tuned. Going to be a short ride up, and then we'll be at the turbot banks, and yeah, I'll give you a quick glimpse of the baits before we start moving up. So I hope you enjoy it, guys. Don't forget to hit the like, subscribe button, and hit that bell right now if you want to see the latest fishing notifications. Anyway, let's get this show on the road, guys. Inglorious Fishing. So guys, just a quick run through of the bait before we go. We got some garfish there, which we'd be cutting into fillets, prime turbot bait them. But to be honest, these are my favorite turbot bait. Mackerel, baby. These are fresh mackerel that we caught yesterday. You'll see that in the previous video. So yeah, and then these are some sand eels, some dead sand eels that we caught yesterday as well. And we'd use them into a flapper rig. So yeah, stay tuned. There's the rods, there's the reels, there's the engine. We're all motored up, baby. Let's get out there. It's Inglorious Fishing. Guys, we arrived at the bank and look at it, it's flat calm, just like yesterday. If I turn this way, you see the bank making out there. There it is. That's the bank making out there, guys. That's the head of the bank. So that's what we're drifting over. This is what we do for turbot fishing. Basically, it's just a sandbank. Here it is. That's it on the plotter there. And we're in the deep part now. And obviously, as the contour lines get lower, that's where the bank is. So we're going to be drifting over that, out for some turbo werbos, baby. So stay tuned. Hopefully, we'll get some once we hit that bank. Possible fish, I'm not sure. No, I don't feel like it now, actually, guys. Probably caught up in my other line now, my luck. Yeah, I think we are. Something was definitely on that, having a munch. Check that out. Guys, possible fish on. I don't think it's a turbo. If it is, no weight at all, really. Where is now? I think it might be a dogfish. If it's a turbo, it's a small one, that's for sure, guys. Oh, I thought it was a bass then. It's a dogfish, guys. Typical dogfish. That's not good. Anyway, stay tuned. We'll get it off the hook. I'll do that now. And then we're going to release this one straight away, guys. We don't need him. Eating my sand eel. He's trying to whip me. Lovely male, this. Just want to be a bit careful with its teeth. There we are, guys. Beautiful. That's the way to take dogfish off. Lovely little dogfish, that. That's the first fish, but that's going to be going back, baby. So take a glimpse of him, because he's going back. Watch this. What a release. Stay tuned, guys. We'll go back up for another drift. Not sure on this, guys. May have another fish on. It's not big. And dogfish, if anything. Got to be a dogfish. I thought it just let go then. Probably big, whatever it is. Yeah, it's a dog, guys. And that's another dogfish. Double walk up. Just a dogfish. There you go. Just regurgitated my mackerel. Lovely, fine, lesser spotted dogfish. Gotta watch his tail because he'll just whip you. So back that one goes, and we're going up for another drift. Look, he's biting on his tail. Look. Back he goes, guys. Let's go up for another one. Hopefully, this ain't the start of something. We want turbos.
You can't beat this, guys. You just can't beat this. Flat calm.
So guys, I've got a line out with a whole mackerel on, and I've just had something take the drag. Hopefully it's not just caught in the bottom. But this is a whole mackerel. Fish on, guys. I think so. Nope, there was something on it though. Bugger. Just drop it back down. We'll check it in a sec when we come up, guys. So I'll turn on the camera when I bring it up and we can have a look what it was. I don't know what the hell that was. Something definitely, the whole line just started going. And like I say, I've got a whole mackerel on this, so must have been something pretty decent. Anyway, I'll give you a glimpse of it when I bring it up. I'm going to stop bringing the lines up anyway. Well, guys, this is a photo of a turbot that I had up there. You're going to see the video after of me showing you the turbot. Unfortunately, the camera mocked up, so I've lost all the footage on that. I wouldn't have been able to upload it because something happened with it. So I hope you enjoy it, guys. Here it is. So, guys, there's a photo of the turbo werbo, baby. Fantastic looking fish, these. I absolutely love them. Their little eyes on the head, their raspy bits in their mouth there. Big mouth in there, guys. Look, check that out. It will swallow anything. And I love this. All the knobbly bits, all the cartilage, hard cartilage on the top. That's how you tell it's a turbot. So anyway, we've got the rods out. We've got our seagulls spectating as usual. They're fighting over there. But hopefully we can get a couple of turbos or a brill. Anyway, stay tuned. So guys, we're up here. And guess what? I'm leaving now. And I'm sorry there ain't a lot of filming. But I have absolutely had nothing other than a few sand eels, that turbot. I can't even remember if we had a dogfish today, guys. So, yeah, stay tuned. I'm sorry there's not as much action as there normally is. I'm going to start making our way in now because the tide's pissing through at 2.5-3 knots. So you're never going to catch turbot like that, guys. So, yeah, I'm going to start making my way in, but I might head to the point. Don't quote me on that, but if I feel like it, I'm going for it, baby. So stay tuned. Hope you enjoy the riding. La la la. So guys, I keep getting asked all these questions. What's the gate? What's the gate? Well, look, this bit of steel here that runs right the way along, that is permanent. Now, what you got round here is that's the gate right there. As you can see, there's a ledge up. Now, that ledge is a gate that goes up and down due to the tidal currents. Now, because the tide ain't high enough yet, we're just waiting. It ain't going to take long because it's a spring tide. But about another 5 minutes, we should be able to get over that, guys. And as you can see, it's pretty shallow. So, yeah, that's the gate. That's how it works. Those bars on the right-hand side, where the pillar is, where the measuring thing is, those are the actual actuators to drop the gate. So, yeah, that's it, guys. So, if I'll give you that. Well, I've got that here. Anyway, be in the harbour shortly. So guys, that's another episode of Inglorious Fishing. We didn't go out fishing, but I'm glad that I didn't, guys, because on the way in, I managed to find both of my strings that are missing. They're caught up in the rocks, so I managed to get one out, but I can't get the other one out. So I'm going to try and get Smash Fishing to go and get it for me when he's foraging tomorrow. But one turbo werbo, baby. You can't moan at that. At least we got one turbo. At least Dad's going to have a meal tonight. Anyway, guys, if you like the channel, like, subscribe. There's going to be plenty more Turbo Wars, baby. So we'll see you on the next adventure. It's Inglorious Fishing. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. And thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.